Joining me now, Elizabeth Boumiller, Pentagon correspondent for the New York Times. You've got the lead story, Elizabeth, today in the Times, where you point out that in an unreleased Pentagon report, 1 in 7 detainees who are released return to jihad. What does that tell you about the likelihood of future releases from Guantanamo ever getting the support of the American public and Congress?
Well, this specific report might make that more difficult. I should say that the report says that, you know, they have actually they are engaged again, and they are engaged in terrorism and militant activity. There's some debate about whether you should say return, because some of them were perhaps not engaged in terrorism. As we know, there's some of them being held there on vague charges. But obviously this complicates things for President Obama considerably, and it's not something that the Pentagon, as we know, was eager to put out. They felt under the new president this might make it look as if they were undermining the president, and so they've sat on that report for a long time, months.
And Elizabeth, there was certainly an attack from Dick Cheney on the New York Times, your newspaper today,
yes,
for some of its reporting, some of its Pulitzer Prize-winning reporting, which he says damaged national security. I know you're not speaking for the institution, but it does put all of us journalists on the firing line here.
Well, we're on the firing line every day from both the left and the right. I think I don't need to remind you of that. And it's just, you know, we're not ideologues here. We're trying to report the news as best we can. And as you know, the vice president has has criticized the Times in the past for that same story.
All right. Elizabeth Boumiller, thank you very much. Thanks for your reporting, as always.